in water. Wade in the water, children. Wade in the water. God, go to trouble in the water. Wade in the water. Wade in the water, children. Wade in the water. God, go to trouble in the water. Where you see that host all dressed in white. God, go to trouble in the water. Hey, look like me, like the Israelite. God, go to trouble in the water. Where you see that man all dressed in red. God, go to trouble in the water. It looked like the band that Moses led. God, go to trouble in the water. Wait in the water. Wait in the water, children. Wait in the water. God, go to trouble in the water. Well, now look over yonder. What do you see? God, go to trouble in the water. The Holy Ghost is coming on me. God, to go to trouble in the water. If you don't believe I've been redeemed, God, to go to trouble in the water. Just follow me down to Jordan Street. God, to go to trouble in the water.
Good afternoon. Truly a great day as we get a chance to celebrate Pentecost this weekend as well as Memorial Day, and I'll do an announcement later about that. But before we begin, I have a pair of glasses that was found in the parking lot. And I think, I don't even know if they're guys or girls, but we'll see. But they'll be back here, and if you're missing them, if you need them during the service, just raise your hand, and we'll make sure. No. There. I'll set them there, and I'll probably forget them. Welcome to those who are online as well, as we get a chance to worship. Note that we have a little bit of a decoration up here. You'll have to wait to see what it all means for Pastor Mike's sermon. I'm Pastor Craig Larson, Pastor Mike. We get a chance to be the pastors here at Desert Hills, and it truly is a joy as we continue to have the celebration of God's Spirit coming into the world on this day, this weekend of Pentecost. For you see, at Desert Hills, we celebrate
grace.
Oh, you are paying attention. We make who? See, I just kind of want to slide that in there just to see if you're actually paying attention. For truly we get a chance to celebrate what God has given to us through the gracious gift of his Son. And today we do get a chance to celebrate his Spirit. We get a chance to take and hear and receive that promise that God has made for all people. A few announcements. Last night was a great night at trivia from the Food, Fun, and Fellowship team. Look forward to the various events that they will be advertising in the future. But last night, I guess, was a great time. So thank you for those who participated. Note that this week, the church office will be closed in recognition of Memorial Day Monday. And so just to be aware of that. Next weekend, remember the first weekend of every month, we do our food drive, and so that will be June 3rd and 4th, and the bins will be set up in the hallways for you to bring the items of food for the food drive. On June 6th, Desert Hills is sponsoring a blood drive from the Red Cross, and so go ahead and sign up through the Red Cross or call the church office, and they'll make sure that you have a good time to give your blood. Oh, I could go, but that's okay. Note also, just to prepare yourself, for the Social Concerns Ministry is beginning a back-to-school drive, and that's going to be June 10th through the 18th. It's a strange thing when we start talking about school in June, as it's just ending up, but for many schools, they start the end of July or 1st of August. So look for more information about what to bring, how to bring, and what is needed. Note that today you'll see that we recognize Memorial Day weekend in a wide variety of ways this weekend. The missing man table, I'd ask that you would take a moment and see and remember. Also, as we celebrate and recognize this Memorial Day weekend, to think of those who you know who have lost their life in battle. Also, those who you know and who are here with us who have served. It's that idea of coming and knowing and believing in something greater than ourselves. And so we do get a chance to live and to worship in this great country that God has created because of and through the promise that we truly are in this together. This time, we'd like to take a moment as we see a video that's played.
They are more than just names. More than blocks of stone set in rows. More than memories. They are our brothers and sisters, our parents and our children, friends, loved ones, and even strangers who believe that we were worth fighting for, that we were worth dying for. They stand for justice, for courage, for heroism, and fearlessness in the face of danger. They stand for the brave men and women who selflessly answered the call and gave their very lives for the cause of freedom. Let us never take their sacrifice for granted, but instead remember with gratitude those who have served. Today, tomorrow, every day thereafter. By the grace of God, if we walk upon free soil, if we breathe in the sweetness of liberty, let us give thanks, let us honor the fallen, and let us never forget.
Let us pray. Almighty God, we come this day to recognize and to remember those who have laid down their life. We are reminded on this Memorial Day weekend, Lord, that freedom is not free. We continue, O God, to live our lives in the reflection and knowing of those who have gave their sacrifice. God, we come also this day and this weekend in the church to celebrate your coming of the Holy Spirit into the world. God, as we have both of those this day, it is that Spirit that you have instilled in each one of us that allows us to take and realize that you continue to act in, amongst, and around us. And Lord, your Spirit so permeates our lives, both past, present, and future, that we can remember those that were in the trenches in World War I, and you were there. To the various conflicts, you were there, giving hope and encouragement. God, we as your church gather this day. Fill us, Lord, with that ability to recognize the Spirit that you have given to each one of us, that allows us to take and be reflective of the love, grace, forgiveness, and peace that you, O God, have given to us. All of this because of and through your blessed Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Amen. We sing our opening songs.
I hope. Jesus said, it is expedient for me to go away, but I'll send you another comforter to guide you from day to day. So they tarried at Jerusalem for power from on high. And that same Spirit that they received within my heart abides. And I can feel His Holy Spirit a dwelling deep within. Well, sometimes it feels so gentle, and sometimes like a mighty rushing wind. That same Spirit that raised Jesus up from death and the grave, it shall raise this old body up and take me home someday. Put soldiers there to guard it. They thought they did away with the Lord. On the third day, the stone was rolled away. He came forth from the grave. And that same Spirit that raised Jesus up is gonna take me home someday. And I feel this Holy Spirit a dwelling within. Well, sometimes it feels so gentle, and sometimes like a mighty rushing wind. That same Spirit that raised Jesus up from death and the grave, it shall raise this old body up and take me home someday.
I've got Jesus.
I've got Jesus
in my soul.
In my soul.
It's the only way I know. Watching every move I make, guiding every step I take. I've got Jesus in my soul. I was lifted one night by God's blinding light, and it shook me right out of my sleep. As his love entered in, it washed away my sin. I praise him down on my knees. I've got Jesus,
I've got Jesus
in my soul.
In my soul.
It's the only way I know. Watching every move I make, guiding every step I take. I've got Jesus in my soul. Even though as a sinner I was no beginner, and I'm glad that I never made the grave. Yes, I'm thankful every day for the prayers that were made. They were answered and my soul was saved. I've got Jesus,
I've got Jesus
in my soul.
In my soul.
It's the only way I know. Watching every move I make, guiding every step I take. I've got Jesus in my soul.
Jesus
in my soul.
In my soul.
It's the only way I know. Watching every move I make, guiding every step I take. I've got Jesus in my soul. I've got Jesus in my soul. I've got Jesus in my soul.
Please join in our litany, spoken responsively. Renew the face of the earth. Renew our lives, inside and out. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Renew our faith. Renew our relationships. Renew our trust in your mercy. Renew our lives, inside and out. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Challenge us, comfort us, stir us up, calm us down. Renew our lives, inside and out. Come, Holy Spirit, come. With fire and wind, come to this place, gather us in. Send us out, renew our lives, inside and out. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Make our legs stronger, our hands firmer, our hearts wider in love. Renew the face of the earth. Come, Holy Spirit, come.
Let the Spirit descend like a beautiful dove. As it did on Jesus that day. He was baptized by John in the river of Jordan. And God's voice like thunder said, "This is my son." When John came preaching, preparing the way for Jesus the heavenly King. If you'll only trust and believe in his word, you'll stand in God's kingdom and not be ashamed. Let the Spirit descend like a beautiful dove, as it did on
Jesus that day. He was baptized by John in the river of Jordan. And God's voice like thunder said, "This is my son." Let the Spirit descend like a beautiful dove, as it did on Jesus that day. He was baptized by John in the river of Jordan. Said, "This is my son." Let the Spirit descend like a beautiful dove.
Today's first scripture reading is from Acts chapter 2, verses 1 through 4. And 12 through 18. When the day of the Pentecost came, they were all together in one place. Suddenly, a sound like the blowing of a violent wind came from heaven and filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. And all of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit enabled them. Amazed and perplexed, they asked one another, "What does this mean?" Some, however, made fun of them and said, "They have had too much wine." Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and addressed the crowd. "Fellow Jews, and all of you who live in Jerusalem, let me explain this to you. Listen carefully to what I say. These people are not drunk, as you suppose. It's only 9 in the morning. No, this is what was spoken by the prophet Joel. In the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy. Your young men will see visions. Your old men will dream dreams. Even on my servants, both men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days, and they will prophesy." The word of the Lord.
Spirit, I need thee. Come, sweet Spirit, I pray. Come in thy strength and your power. Come in your own gentle way. Come as a rest to the weary. Come as a balm to the sore. Come, Lord, as strength to my weakness. Fill me with joy evermore. Come, Holy Spirit, I need thee. Come, sweet Spirit, I pray. Come in thy strength and your power. Come in your own gentle way. come like a spring in the desert. Come to the withered of soul. Lord, let thy sweet healing power touch me and make me whole. Come, Holy Spirit, I need thee. Come, sweet Spirit, I pray. Come in thy strength and your power. Come in your own gentle way. Come, Holy Spirit, I need thee. Come, sweet Spirit, I pray. Come in thy strength and your power. Come in your own gentle way. Come in your own gentle way.
Today's second scripture reading is from the Gospel of John, chapter 7, verses 37 through 39. On the last and greatest day of the festival, Jesus stood and said in a loud voice, "Let anyone who is thirsty come to me and drink. Whoever believes in me, as scripture has said, rivers of living water will flow from within them." By this he meant in the Spirit, whom those who believed in him were later to receive. Up to that time, the Spirit had not been given, since Jesus had not yet been glorified. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come to us who gather here in the sanctuary, those of us who gather online. Come, because we need you. Our souls are thirsting. We need your renewal. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Amen. Today is the celebration of Pentecost, the coming of the Spirit. It's the birthday of the church. And oftentimes when we celebrate Pentecost, we talk about fire. We hear in the book of Acts that the disciples see tongues of fire on them. That fire is oftentimes the image that Scripture uses to describe the Spirit. We have today the color red symbolizing fire. We have the banners symbolizing fire. The cleansing fire of God that burns away the impurities and leaves behind that which is holy. But today I want us to turn our attention not to fire, but to water. Because water is also an image that Scripture uses to describe the Spirit. Jesus says, "I give living water." Today's gospel, you hear Jesus says, "All those who thirst, come to me and I will give you life-giving water." Water is also a sign of God's Spirit. Because the reality is, there is no one image that can begin to capture the presence and Spirit of God. There is multiple images of the Spirit. It's fire, it's water, it's wind, it's a still, quiet voice. So many different images in Scripture to describe a reality that is beyond our words, but a reality that we desperately need in our lives and in the world. Come, Holy Spirit, come. So today I want us to think about the Holy Spirit with its understanding of water. And I want us to begin to think about this with this famous picture that was painted many years ago. You can get that. There it is. You probably all seen it. You probably grew up in churches where this image was in almost every Sunday school room, definitely in a hallway somewhere. It's Jesus knocking on the door. And if you were like me, I was told as a child, this is Jesus knocking on the door of my heart because Jesus wants in. How many of you were told that? You can raise your hand. Yeah, most of you, right? This is a famous image. And oftentimes, that's how it's described. Jesus knocking on our hearts to come into our lives. Well, today I want us to think about this image a little broader. So at the end of today, I hope you think about this image of Jesus knocking on your heart from a different perspective. And we're going to do that by using this simple picture. Many of you may wonder, what does this mean? Well, sisters and brothers in Christ, this is your life. You're like a vessel. You're like a vessel that gets filled. And if you think about it, you fill your lives with many things, don't you? You fill your lives with images, with thoughts, with relationships. Our lives are filled throughout our lifetime, and that which fills us causes us to act in certain ways. Well, today Jesus tells us that those who hunger and thirst, those who long to have the Spirit, is filled by the Spirit. So I want us to imagine that this is the Spirit of God filling your life. Now, imagine that I keep adding more and more and more water, symbolizing how the Spirit of God continues to fill you all the way to the very top. Now, what happens when it's filled to the very top? Can't be filled anymore, can it? There's no more Spirit that can be added to this because it's full. There's no room for it to go. And Jesus says that we are blessed not just for ourselves, but to be a blessing. The Dead Sea, the reason it's dead is not because it's not filled. It's because there's nowhere for it to go. It only goes in. It does not go out. So all the things left behind causes the sea to die. And in some sense, if we see our lives as only being filled, we lose opportunities for the Spirit to continue to come into our lives. When the Spirit fills us completely, there's nowhere for it to go. But what if? What if not only are we filled, but we begin to drain and share the blessings of God with others? I can continue to add, and it never fills up. It continues to flow in, and it flows out. It allows the Spirit to continue to work in my life, but it allows me also to share the blessings of God with others. Now, what would happen if I just let it go and never filled it anymore? It would dry up. How many of you have been on an airplane? And the stewardess is standing there, and he or she is saying, oh, it's dripping all over the place. This is a test. We know what works, it does not work. Hopefully it stays there. And the flight attendant is standing there, and they grab an airbag, and they say, oh, fall down, you pull it down, and what do? You put it on whose face first, you or the one you're caring for? You. And why do you put it on you and not the one you're caring for? The vulnerable one, the one that needs it and needs help getting it. They tell you every time. Why? Because you have to take care of yourself before you can help someone else. Well, sisters and brothers in Christ, if you simply allow your spirit to be drained and doesn't continue to fill it with God's presence, you will dry out. Not only will you dry out, or you will start to look for other things to satisfy that thirst. Things that are not life-giving. You will fill it with resentment or anger or other things that tend to be destructive to our lives when we're simply giving ourselves and never filling ourselves up with God's grace and God's Spirit. God does not want us just to drain ourselves. God wants us to be continuously filled as we bless others. I'll turn that off because it's probably annoying after a while. And it goes all over the floor. Luckily, it's water. It dries. But do you see how life works? This is what Jesus is talking about, the gifts of the Spirit. If you notice the gifts of the Spirit, it always is given so that it can flow out to other people. The gift of love can't be held in itself. It has to be shared. The gift of peace is shared, even though you receive the benefits as well. That God wants to fill our lives with life-giving water. Because God knows that we're thirsting. We're thirsting for love. We're thirsting for purpose. We're thirsting for meaning. You'll hear so often that people are leaving the church, that people are leaving the faith. But if you also read the research, people are seeking more than ever something to believe in. It's not that they're not wanting something to believe. It's not that they don't want purpose. They just don't know where to find life-giving water. And our gift, our blessing is that we know where life-giving water comes from. It's not from us. It's from the gift of the Holy Spirit. It's not us blessing them. It's God blessing them through us. Jesus is the life-giving water. We are simply the container in which God fills so that we can fill others with that same Spirit, that same life-giving water. That's what we're celebrating today. That Jesus wants to fill each and every one of us so that we can offer to others who are thirsting. Thirsting for life. Thirsting for love. Thirsting to belong. Thirsting for purpose. We find that in the gifts of the Spirit. As God fills us with life-giving water that we can share. That can flow through us into the world. Jesus says, as he fills us with a river of life, it flows out of our hearts into the world. In that image of Jesus knocking on the door to enter our hearts, that is one part of the equation. But I think Jesus also knocks on our doors of our hearts so that he can get out and loose in the world with us. That Jesus doesn't just want to live here. He wants to live through you into the world. The world that he loves. The world that he came to save. The world in which we have been blessed so we can be a blessing too. On this Memorial Day weekend, when we remember and honor those who gave their lives so that we can sit here today. Those who gave the blessings that they were given in the ultimate sacrifice. We are reminded that we have a Savior that did the same, who gave his life for all of us so that we can be blessed with life-giving water, not to keep it for ourselves, but to let it flow. Let it flow so that we can be continuously filled, so that we never have to thirst. We never have to wonder, are we loved? Does our lives have meaning? Because we have been quenched. Our thirst has been satisfied with a life-giving water of God. So if you'd like to dig today's a little deeper, I invite you to think about this. What are you thirsting for? What are you thirsting for? And how might your faith satisfy that thirst? What is it that you go and seek to satisfy that thirst inside of you? And does it bring you that which you want? Or does it leave you only wanting more? Let the life-giving waters of God fill you so that you may fill others through that same love and grace. Amen.
To the river of Jordan, our Savior went one day, and we read that John the Baptist met him there. When John baptized Jesus in Jordan's rushing waters, the mighty power of God filled the air. I'm on my way, gonna raid right in, I'm going down to the river of Jordan. Let the cool waters cleanse my soul. King Naaman was stricken with dreaded leprosy, and he sent for the man of God to pray. But Elisha said to Naaman, go dip yourself in Jordan. Let the cool water wash your spots away. I'm on my way, gonna wade right in. I'm going down to the river of Jordan. And let the cool waters cleanse my soul. To the river of Jordan is many miles away. This mighty river I may never see, but I'll find myself an altar in an old-fashioned church. My river of Jordan, that will be. I'm on my way, I'm gonna wade right in. I'm going down to the river of Jordan. And let the cool waters cleanse my soul.
Together, let us affirm our faith with the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate and was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We will now have the gathering of offerings.
As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, brothers, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, brothers, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, fathers, let's go down, come on down. Oh, fathers, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, mothers, let's go down, come on down, don't you wanna go down? Oh, mothers, let's go down, down in the river to pray. To pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, people, let's go down, come on down. Oh, people, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way.
The psalmist declares in Psalm 104 the wonder of God. Praise the Lord, my soul. Lord, my God, you are very great. You are clothed with splendor and majesty. He makes springs pour water into the ravines. It flows between the mountains. They give water to all the beasts of the field. The wild donkeys quench their thirst. The birds of the sky nest by the waters. They sing among the branches. He waters the mountains from his upper chambers. The land is satisfied by the fruit of his work. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works. He who looks at the earth and it trembles, who touches the mountains and they smoke. I will sing to the Lord all my life. I will sing praise to my God as long as I live. May my meditation be pleasing to him as I rejoice in the Lord. Let us pray. We remember those who have recently died, including Brad Nelson, Clancy Smith, and Jean Wyman. Oh God, receive them into the arms of your mercy and everlasting peace, and may the truth and promise of God's resurrection bring comfort and hope to their families and friends who grieve. God of new life, bring us hope. New to our prayer list are Ron Smeltzer and family. Leaving the prayer list with thanksgiving for healing is Nancy Kramer. We take time now to silently pray for those who remain on our prayer list, as well as for others in our hearts and for situations in our lives. Holy Spirit, we pray that you renew us through your living water so that our spirits are refreshed and nourished. Make us bold witnesses to the truth of the Holy Scriptures which you inspired. God of new life, bring us hope. God of peace, we pray for those who have served our nation and have laid down their lives to protect and defend our freedom. We pray for those who have fought, those who did not return to their loved ones, whose spirits and bodies are scarred by war, whose rights are haunted by memories too painful for the light of day. We pray for those who serve us now, especially for those in harm's way. Shield them from danger and bring them home. Turn the hearts and minds of our leaders and our enemies to the work of justice and a harvest of peace. God of new life, bring us hope. Holy God, watch over all those who are in times of transitions. There are many who are graduating from high school or college, preparing with a sense of uncertainty for what lays ahead. Many of us face our own transitions as we deal with issues of health, grieving, or struggling with purpose. Fill us with your guiding spirit so that we might know we are never alone in our transitions or times of struggle. God of new life, bring us hope. Pour out your Holy Spirit, Lord, on us. May we, together with all believers, be filled with awe at what the crucified, risen, and ascended Savior has accomplished for our fallen world. May we be inflamed to speak and live as those in whom the Spirit lives. God of new life, bring us hope. Let us join our voices together as we pray the prayer that Jesus has taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
We pray that this service has been a blessing for those that are here, for those that are online, as we are reminded always of this day of God's Spirit and the promise that He gives. So hear this blessing. May the living waters of the Spirit flow through your body. May the burning fire of the Spirit warm your heart. May the rushing wind of the Spirit fill your lungs, inspiring you to new words and deeds, all in the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please stand as we sing our closing songs.
Let's all go down to the river. There's a man who's walking on the water. Come along with me, for I want to see this man walking on the water. Well, he can raise the dead from the grave, change the water and turn it into wine. He can make the lame walk, he can make the mute talk, and open up the eyes of the blind. Let's all go down to the river. There's a man who's walking on the water. Come along with me, for I want to see this man walking on the water. Jesus is the man at the river, and he's washing people's sins away. He can save the soul if you give him control. Be ready for that judgment day. Let's all go down to the river. There's a man who's walking on the water. Come along with me, for I want to see this man walking on the water. Let's all go down to the river. There's a man who's walking on the water. Come along with me, for I want to see this man walking on the water.
Filled with the gift of the Holy Spirit, we live our lives renewed. Amen.
Let's all go down to the river. There's a man who's walking on the water. Come along with me, for I want to see this man walking on the water. Let's all go down to the river. There's a man who's walking on the water. Come along with me, for I want to see this man.